Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. The story of the Lost Child by Mulkraj Anand is about a young boy's innocence and his bond with his parents. Let us read the summary. It is a bright spring day. There is a fair going on and everyone in and around the village is traveling to partake of the delights of the fair. Among them is a young boy. He skips and runs happily alongside his parents as they walk to the fair. There are many people traveling along with them. Some of them are moving in bullock carts or horses, while some of them are walking to the fair. The boy's excitement grows as he sees all the people around them. On his way, he sees a toy shop. He loudly proclaims that he wants a toy. His father looks at him sternly. To divert the child's attention, his mother draws his attention towards the mustard fields, which are yellow in color. There is a vast field of golden yellow mustard fields, and its color excites the boy. The field is also filled with butterflies. The boy is fascinated by these wonderful butterflies. As they fly close to him, he tries to catch some of them, but they elude him. His parents call out to him to join them. They have taken shelter in a shaded grove. As soon as the boy enters the grove, a shower of flowers greets him and he holds out his hands to catch the petals. The boy looks around in wonder, taking in all the sights and sounds of nature. From the grove, they travel along a narrow path to the fair. From the serene world of nature, the boy enters into the world of the beautiful fair. Its cacophony, sights and smells fascinate and repel him at the same time. The boy stops in front of a sweet shop, tempted by the delightful display of sweets. He wants a burfi, though he knows his parents will not buy it for him. As they walk on, he is attracted by the beautiful garlands of Gulmohar in the next shop. Though he wants one around his neck, he knows his parents will call it cheap and refuse him. Brightly colored balloons on a pole greet him next. He stops and gazes at the bright balloons floating in the air. He knows his parents will tell him he is too old to play with them. So, he moves on to where a snake charmer is playing his flute. He wants to hear the music, but he knows his parents will forbid it. Finally, he reaches the giant wheel. His eyes shine at the giant wheel, keeping on turning with all its brightly colored lights and people laughing and shouting. He cannot contain himself any longer and clamors to get on it, but his parents do not reply. He turns around, but his parents are not with him any longer. Frightened, he runs and starts howling. He runs here and there trying to find his parents. There are tears in his eyes and his clothes become dirty. He notices a temple around which many people are gathered. He hopes he can find his parents there, but there are too many people and he cannot see them. A kind stranger rescues him from the stampede of people. The stranger asks the boy who his parents are, but the boy cannot tell him anything. He only repeats that he wants his father and mother. The stranger then takes him to the roundabout and asks whether he wants a ride, but the child does not want one anymore. The stranger then takes him to the snake charmer, asking him if he wants to hear the music. But the child closes his ears, crying for his parents again. He shakes his head at the pretty balloons. He refuses to put a garland around his neck. Finally, the stranger takes him to the sweet shop, but the child cannot be consoled by the sweets also. He continues to keep on crying for his parents. Thank you.